First up on the stage tonight, and I don't want to put these under pressure to be ready, you let me know when you're ready. We're going to have Mary Clancy's class. Mary Clancy, down the front here in front of me here, who has kept the flag flying for set dancing and hair over the years. And usually it would be her daughter Mary Kate who'd give her a dig out, but fair play to the Marys. There's another Mary on the scene, and it's Mary Anna, who arrived, Mary Kate, baby girl, very recently. Mary Anna, another one to keep the dancing going. So in the meantime, Mary was ably assisted by Pat O'Dea, and he brought class, Mary's class, through various sets, and they're going to do two figures of the Kilfenora set to get us underway tonight, I hope. So I'll ask them to come up and they can smile at you for a while we get the musician sorted. Okay? So we'll have Pat O'Dea with Mary Clancy's dancers, please, if they can find the stage, if they're not stuck in Aina in a traffic jam. Did you see Bobby Gardner getting up there with the Mulcahys? Hey, Bobby. Woo! next on our agenda will be the Dan Fury group. Now, Dan Fury was a dancing master who lived down around Labashiada and who kept alive very traditional step dances, solo step dances. He taught dancing in the vicinity. From that, we have Maureen O'Reilly, who has taken on the baton from Dan, from Celine, from Michael, and she has some dancers who are going to dance the easy jig. They danced in Maureen's class. Maureen O'Reilly is a powerhouse because she danced the priest in his boots with the Dan Fury group. She led her class through the easy jig, and now she's going to dance a thing called the Little Dutch dance, which was a dance that Celine Tuberty learnt as a child in Donegal, and she taught it to people down here over the years, and it's one of those ones that has been captured for posterity's sake lovely dance to have a go at. It's kind of dance to a little mazurka. To have the other baton carrier. It looks as if I'm carrying batons here, but I'm just carrying water because I think these might need water over there. Noel Devery, who has taken on the baton from Dan Fury, from Celine Tuberty, from Michael Tuberty, and Noel's class, and it's a beautiful hornpipe. Thank you. was Celine Chubbardy's hornpipe, which she learned from Seamus Kerrigan in the 1930s in Gortahurk. I believe we have Mairead Casey, a woman extraordinaire from Longford. Am I right? Yay! This is the conflab over there. Mairead is a fabulous step dancer, Shannos dancer, teacher. She possibly makes brown bread in her spare time, I'm not sure, okay? And she is going to do some, I think it's Shannos you're going to do rather than step, but she's just going to respond to the music. She'll listen to the music, she'll respond to the music, and we'll love it. Off you go. surprise package was, and the surprise package was the inimitable Mick Mulcairn. Okay. He said he slept it out. I think, was that bed hair I saw on Mick Mulcairn? Okay. Now they were working all week down in the Marquee, teaching Shannos dancing to some people who are total beginners. Beginners from Monday, some of them. Okay? So this is the class that Mairead and Michael were working with. And they're going to do a few steps to reels again. I presume Mairead will tell you, talk you through what it is. On stage is Rosie Davis, who has been giving us a hand here in Brooks Academy with the set dancing in the hall. She's also fantastic, all kinds of dancer, and she's the woman whose talents, if I was to stand up here and tell you what she can do, you wouldn't believe the half of the things that this woman can do. Tonight she's going to be doing some Appalachian, I'll get it right maybe, Appalachian flat footing to a tune I think is called The Blind Steer in the Mud Hole. And it's Jeremy Diamond who's going to play, and it might take a bit of time to get us organised with this. Okay? Talk among yourselves, and if anybody comes around selling raffle tickets, it's a scam. Don't believe them. Don't believe them. Rosie is from, I'm going to get it wrong, but around Liverpool. Dermy is from around Belfast. Dermy's just pretending to be banjaxed, but we know.
Yes.
We know. We're delighted Dermy came, because there are stories about times that we won't talk about. Anyway, you're here, Dermy. Thanks very much. You!
I'm very expensive. More expensive than Ryan Tuberby.
Thank you.
as I said, Rosie was giving us a dig out with the class here, Brooks Academy in the hall, and we started off the week doing Set Corcovina. Now, we're in Dublin, and we learned the sets in Clare and in various parts of the world. And one of the sets we learned was from this man here who's getting himself organised, Brandon O'Begliach. And it was his local set from Corcovina, sometimes called the West Kerry set, that he and his family, and eventually his dad, gave us the imprimatur. Is that what the Pope gives you, or a bishop or something, and said, yeah, you kind of have the hang of it. So we did it on Monday here, and it was a total pleasure to realise that among our dancers, we had the granddad's two granddaughters. We had Brandon's daughter, Cliona, and his wonderful brother's, Seamus's daughter, Maeve. So, Fáilte.
Thank you.
we're going to have another fantastic, actually more than one, fantastic stalwart of the Willie Clancy Summer School. Bobby Gardner is going to play, and Michelle Mulcahy is going to play for Aidan Vaughan, very local to here, who's going to do some interpretations, shannos, battering, whatever it is that he feels like doing to the wonderful reels that he's going to hear. Aidan has been teaching here for the last several years, and he's about to show you what you're going to try and emulate when you come to his classes. So Aidan Vaughan, the very, very local Aidan Vaughan, the boy next door. Next up is Martin Hughes from Mayo. Martin last year saved the show completely. It was the Martin Hughes show last year, because Martin was like Mick Tuberty, because he was dancing and playing and doing everything under the sun. Tonight he's probably doing it a little bit less, but he's probably going to be doing a bit of the dancing and the playing and everything. This time he's going to dance the Blackbird.
Thank you.
Hilton, regular dancer, set dancer here in the Dwilly Clancy Week, is also a Morris dancer. And a few years ago, he gave us a taster of Morris dancing, and he's going to do the same again. We have Neil Bettinson, a face that's very, very familiar around Milltown, who's going to play the jig for him, which is the Morris. It's a Morris jig, and I think it's called the Princess Royal. Okay. It turns out Tim learned this from a dancer in Sussex, which, as far as I know, is in the far south of England. And Neil lives in Cumbria, which, as far as I know, is in the far north west of England. And they never met until a couple of days ago when we were looking for someone to play for Tim. And in the course of conversation, they discovered that the teacher who taught Tim in Sussex is a good friend of Neil's, even though they had never met before. So behave yourselves when you're on holidays, because there's always somebody who knows something about you or make a connection. Okay? So a Morris jig, the Princess Royal, from Neil Bettinson and Tim McGilton. Thank you, lads. Next person is Finn Moore, and Finn is from Scotland. I know that Sarah told me she's from Edinburgh. Sarah Hoy is going to play fiddle for Finn, and Finn is going to do some, Scottish step dancing. I was looking at it earlier, and I just saw him today doing it, and I asked him would he come and do it this evening. And it reminded me of Cape Breton dancing. And Finn was saying that the Cape Breton dancing probably went from Scotland over to Cape Breton. While it died out or was forgotten by vast majority of people in Scotland, except for some elderly ladies. Elderly ladies, the world needs you. But it was kept alive in Cape Breton and has been kind of reintroduced as such, maybe. So again, we're looking at how our lives are tangled up all over the world. This is Finn and Sarah with some more steps for you. Thanks very much, folks. Yeah.
Thank you.